Hello everyone, welcome to our channel DexLab Analytics. My name is Niharika Rai and this is part 3 of regular expression videos. If you haven't watched my previous videos, you can click on the I button on the top right side corner of your screen. In this particular video, I will be talking about what is the difference between match method and search method and how you can substitute various words based on the patterns you make. Also, we will be elaborating on the kind of patterns we can build based on our meta characters, which we have discussed in our previous video. So without wasting any further time, let's get started. Again, here we are importing the RE library, that is regular expression library, and for this particular video we are taking the Hello DexLab example. And to extract, this is just a revision. To extract this Hello DexLab entirely, we are using this period meta character, which states that you can extract anything, alphanumeric data or numerical data or special character, and this asterisk sign means that you can do that 0 times or more times. So we are going to extract alphanumeric characters and as well as special characters here with the help of this method or meta character combination. So here we are using re.compile method to build our pattern, and then to extract the pattern we are using match method again. Hello DexLab, and this, once we run this entire thing, you see that we got the Hello DexLab text here. If you want to extract only the text part, you can extract it with the help of the slice operator. I'm mentioning 0 here. So everything which is being extracted or being taken up from this string is on the 0 index of the list, you can say. So that's it. Now if I want to replace this hello with hi, how can I do that? We are going to see that. Now there is something called a substitute method. In regex or in regular expression library, sub is the method which helps you substitute things or strings in particular. So what you can do is, you are going to first use re.sub, and then right after that, by the way, this r is nothing but it means that read something as it is. If you want to place it, you can. If you don't want to place it, you can completely remove it. It's your choice, but it basically means read things as it is. So when you are giving permission to something, then you can write read, write and execute. Here we are just reading the text, so that is why we are adding r. So here, and this permission is only given to this part of the text, which is our pattern here. So here you can use re.substitute method, and you can write read hello as it is, comma, wherever there is hello, replace it with hi. So you see there is a pattern here. First you have to write what you want to replace with what you want to replace and in which text you want to replace. So here I have Hello DexLab as my text, and I want this hello to be replaced by hi. So I'm using this pattern here, but here we have directly written hello, and we haven't used any sort of pattern here. We have just written the literal meaning of hello. We have used just literal here. Okay, if we run that, we see that hello has already converted to hi, replaced by hi. Now if I want to make it more flexible, so for making it more flexible, I'm going to use a pattern instead of using something as literal here. So for that, what I'm doing is I'm using re.compile. We all know that re.compile helps us build and combine our pattern. Now we are using, within that we are making a pattern. So Let's understand the meaning of this pattern first. Read the pattern as it is, starting with parenthesis. Here, parenthesis means that the entire thing should be as a whole. When in my previous video we talked about what these meta characters mean. So parenthesis means that match everything exactly as it is in the parenthesis and not a part of it. Right. So here I have parenthesis, and within that parenthesis I am saying that the first letter is going to be capital. And since I am not using any combination, and I am saying the square bracket means that match anything once, only one character match. Okay, so I am saying that the pattern starts with a capital letter and it can be anything. And then the rest of the word or the rest of the letters are in small letter. But then I have more than one letters. You can see that I have more than one alphabets in small. So for that reason, I am adding a plus sign here, which basically means that search or find something, you can say find something or match something which is appearing one time or more time. So it is also included, like if you want to write H-E-L-L, if you want to find H-E-L-L-O hello, so with this plus sign you can match hello entirely, because it can be like appearing anything one time or more time here. Okay, so now we are closing the parenthesis. Now this entire thing says that my first letter will be, my first character will be a capital, and the rest of it will be in small letters, characters, and it can be one or more letters added together. So now the property of square brackets is entirely changed from matching a single letter only to more than one letter match. Now what we are going to do is we are using this pattern dot substitute method, and we are writing what we want to substitute, because we have already applied. We are again using object oriented programming here, and we have already matched the pattern. We have already made the pattern, not matched the pattern. We have already made the pattern, and now on the top of it, I am mentioning this substitute method. So now I am not going to write find this, because it's already included in the first part. Okay, the pattern is already included in the first part. Now all I need to do is with what I want to replace and what is my text. So let's run that. Here you see, we did the same thing, but in a slight different manner. Now, if it is not hello, P it is, then also it's replacing, right? So we have made it quite flexible by saying that it might not be the case that it is only hello that is starting, or it is not only the hello word that is in the beginning of the line or at the end. We will talk about that later, but it can be any word that starts with H, capital H, or A, B, C, anything, and has a combination of other lowercase characters here. So even if I write Pello here, it is being replaced. Now in any case, if in the above code we write Pello, we won't be able to replace it, because we have a pattern which is not flexible, and it only says that if and only if there is a letter, there is a word that is hello, change it to hi. But in this case, since we have made it flexible, it's saying anything with a capital letter combined with lowercase characters change that. Hence, we have high instead of pelu as well. Now, as we all know that match method always matches anything in the beginning of the text. But search method is something which matches anything from the entire text. It can be anything, and not only it will search not only in the beginning but also in the entire text. So you will be able to extract a data with the help of a pattern. Like I am writing here hello, so I want to match hello here, and it might be a case that the hello is not at the end, at the beginning, not at the end, but in middle of my string. So if I want to extract that, I can do that with the help of search method here. But the only problem with this search method is that it matches anything only single time. So here, since hello was at the starting of the line or string, it matched it there and stopped searching for rest of the hellos and gave us the index number of only the first incident where we found hello and not the rest of the hello. So that's that. Now let's play quickly place the above pattern, this pattern here in the search method. Okay, so we are using the same string with the same pattern. Now hello is this entire thing is not flexible. Again, we want something flexible so that even if the first letter is hello and it should match that, right? So we want something flexible. So here in re.compile, I am writing this pattern again, which says match anything which starts with a capital letter, but match it only once. Then use small letter which is already attached in that capital letter or combined to that capital letter, and that can be not once but can be n number of times. So if I remove this plus sign, I will only get PE, because as I said, square bracket means it has a property that it matches anything but only one time. That means A to Z, anything which comes only one time, it is going to match. So we have added this plus sign. We have also used again square brackets 0 to extract the data. Now you might now suppose that I want to build an entirely new pattern. Now suppose that I want DexLab also to be included in this. Okay, so for that what I'm going to do is I'm going to extend this entire pattern. For that I'm using a space here. After that space, I am saying that the next letter should be in small letter, and this can be one time or more time. So hello, DexLab. Now the first letter is separated by, the first word is separated by a space, and then the second word is actually in small letters. Now if I want to further elaborate on that, then I'll again just add this pattern here. Now we have Hello DexLab Hello. Suppose that this is in small letter, and then I run it. Then in that case, what will happen is that I will have to use this particular pattern here. Hello, DexLab, hello. Suppose that it may or may not be the case that the space is there. That doesn't matter because this particular pattern is actually saying that match anything with small letters. So even if you do not add this, it's okay. Now this was it for this video. If you want to know more about DexLab Analytics, or if you want the code sheet of this Jupyter Notebook, you can just click on the link down below. And please, if you like this video, click on the like button, also subscribe. And if you want to hear more from me, please click on the bell button. Bye bye, take care.